Hi everyone, I am Paola Moretti, I am a conservation scientist, an art restorer and a member of the UCOC organization. As a part of your art, UCOC Urban Art Working Group, I'm going to talk to you about the results of the UCOC Technical Scientific Research, which is focused on the evaluation of the performance of protective coatings applied on outdoor contemporary murals. The idea behind the research was born in 2014, thanks to the collaboration with Muro Project's curator and street artist David Vecchiato, who showed us several urban artworks damaged by vandalism. Graffiti vandalism, as understood today, consists of scratching, drawing, or painting using a wide range of materials, including graffiti markers, spray paints, ballpoint pen ink, correcting fluid, wax crayons, lipstick, and others. Addressing the issue about the long-term care and maintenance of urban artwork raises a critical question. Is it possible to protect urban artworks against graffiti vandalism? From a scientific point of view, the answer to this question is really complex. Observing the scanning electron microscope cross-section of samples collected, you can see the deep interaction between the painting layers and applied vandalism layers. The removal of graffiti products is done using mechanical, chemical, or laser methods. These methods, however, are generally harsh and may result in an acceptable level of surface damage. As one can easily image, in order to clean properly, it can be very difficult to remove vandalism layer from a mural art surface without damaging the underlying painting layer. Often, the paint layers and the vandal layer are composed of the same chemical composition. Therefore, the cleaning solution by dissolving the vandalism can dissolve the substrate as well. Our research started from the study of anti-graffiti coating, which is a layer of material applied on the surface of another material, usually stone, with the intent to limit damage from vandalism, preventing graffiti paints from penetrating into the substrate. May these products be used to protect outdoor mural painted surfaces? How can we use them to obtain the best results? Documentation is a key aspect in artwork conservation. Thanks to an exhaustive bibliographical review, it has been possible to plan a research project focused on the evaluation of suitability of applying a coating to protect urban artworks and the formulation of a new eligible anti-graffiti that started from the previous studies. Obviously, the research is aimed to verify the new product's efficacy by monitoring its effectiveness over time. The experimental research has been divided into steps. Experiments conducted in a laboratory setting focused on studying the interaction of anti-graffiti products on common synthetic paints, testing the effectiveness and efficiency of several commercial products used as anti-graffiti, defining the best procedure to remove vandalism paint from a coated surface, testing a new anti-graffiti coating, and experiments conducted in field setting, focused on testing the effectiveness of better products, comparing them in a real case study, and monitoring the protective coating durability and performance over time. As you can see from the same image, a suitable anti-graffiti coating can produce a protective barrier against the colorants and dyes contained in the sprays, markers, and other materials used to make graffiti. Intuitively, this could facilitate the removal of vandalism paint without damaging the original painted surface. Selecting the best product is not so easy, it depends on many factors. Starting from the knowledge of the constituent material, in order to choose the best product, we must consider the coating features in terms of stability, compatibility, transparency, a low surface energy, effectiveness, ease of application, not to mention the durability under outdoor conditions, reversibility, permeability to water vapor, water repellents, chemical inertia, and the maintenance of the chromatic values. Anti-graffiti products can be divided into two main groups: sacrificial and permanent coatings. Specifically, sacrificial products are generally composed of waxes, acrylates, and polysaccharides. Permanent anti-graffiti coatings are generally composed of polyurethanes, fluorocarbon, and alkyl alkoxysilanes. Acrylics, vinyls, partially fluorinated acrylics, and siloxan are the main classes of polymers used for the protection of outdoor architectural elements. In the first phase of the research, a screening activity has been carried out in order to choose which anti-graffiti was the most suitable for a deeper investigation. At first, tests have been performed on laboratory specimens and at later stage in the field on artwork case studies. In this study, 6 anti-graffiti commercial coatings and 4 different colored paint have been applied on laboratory specimens, which reproduce a street artwork common stratigraphy and material. This slide shows the stratigraphic sequences of the laboratory specimens, which simulate a street art artwork. To evaluate the best performance and durability among the different coatings, all specimens have been analyzed through visual inspection of the surface, colorimetric measurements, applicability, cleaning tests, microscopic and spectroscopic investigation, and monitored before and after several aging cycles. Some of the tested anti-graffiti coatings showed a low effectiveness, in some cases induced surface chromatic alteration of the paint layer, especially bleaching, yellowing, and glossy surface. According to the positive results of the diagnostic analysis, it has been possible to select a suitable commercial product among the 6 different ones tested, which respond to the conservation requirements previously reported, and which shows the best behavior, Proston. At this point, thanks to a commercial agreement with the Pellicott company, a specific coating product has been formulated in order to optimize the Proston product, named ProArt. The scanning electron microscope images show the ProArt's ability to form a clear thin coat barrier between the paint surface and the applied vandalic layer. The anti-graffiti do not penetrate under the underlying paints and do not produce a significant colorimetric alteration of the surface. The first experiment phase was followed by a several cleaning tests performed on the specimen surfaces coated with ProArt in order to select the best procedure for removing graffiti. The results of the cleaning procedures were evaluated considering both the graffiti remains and the alteration induced on the surface, and it proved the coating's subtle selective cleaning ability. Thanks to positive laboratory results, it has been decided to test the ProArt on a real case study in a field setting. The Geisha, made by Finduck. This artwork has been highly damaged by vandalism, and the artist, considering the gravity of the situation, intended to come back to Rome to remade it. Our research looked for a solution to the conservation problem, which would avoid the artist remaking the artwork. The experiment has been carried out comparing the new ProArt formula to the commercial product AGO9W, which has shown better results with Proston during the preliminary laboratory phase, in order to choose the best performer. After applying ProArt and AGO9W on limited portion of the surface and after waiting for the products to dry, a modified alkyd resin-based black spray paint, which is the same black paint used by Finduck, was applied to the protected surface to simulate an act of vandalism. Removal tests of the vandalistic black layer have been performed, firstly by using poultices with cotton and hydroalcoholic mixture, and after that by gently wiping with a cotton swab. The treated surfaces were evaluated considering the black paint remains and the alterations induced on the surface. The spray Montana 94 has been used both by the artist in the black background and for the vandalic simulation in order to test ProArt's ability to form a performance barrier. The image clearly demonstrates its effectiveness and how a suitable cleaning solution was able to selectively solubilize the upper layers without affecting the original painted layers. Regarding the cleaning test, the ProArt treatment has shown a better behavior compared to cane coating. In addition, results suggest that the anti-graffiti ProArt does not penetrate into the underlying paint and does not produce a significant colorimetric alteration of the surface. The image shows the geisha after the restoration. The research has been implemented by applying ProArt coating in several urban artworks belonging to Muro and Grad project and by monitoring its effectiveness over time and after being vandalized, as you can see in this street artwork by Buffmaster. ProArt coating have proved to be good barrier layer against graffiti vandalism. It should definitely be considered as a preventive measure when a mural is under the threat of graffiti vandalism. The research path was made possible thanks to the commitment and work of Jokokwer and various partners, in particular the contribution provided by two Erasmus projects and the collaboration of their respective students, Margarita Castro and Claudia Corbello, helped the development and implementation of the research. At the end of this process, the importance of finding the best method to remove graffiti became even more evident, as the threat of this type of vandalism is constant. Further research is needed to evaluate other case studies and optimize the coating original formulation in order to use it as a preventive conservation measure for outdoor contemporary murals and to make it more suitable to wild-end purposes. The experimentation is still ongoing and Jokoku is open for discussions and exchanges ideas with those interested. Thanks for the attention.